Trolice Fertility CARE, the IVF Center. Happy Monday. For those of you who celebrate Easter, I hope you all had a wonderful Easter. And those of you who Passover, happy Passover. So today we're going to talk about ovarian drilling. And when I use the term ovarian drilling, the eyes of patients bug out. They can't believe the word drilling. But it's a very tried and true procedure that we've known for many, many years. As you saw the post a few days ago, I spoke at the World Congress on Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome, and the origins of ovarian drilling came from the very, very early days with managing polycystic ovarian syndrome and diagnosing it. These patients had large ovaries, and they surgically removed a wedge of the ovary, and it was called ovarian wedge resection. And patients started ovulating regularly. They thought that that was a treatment and also trying to diagnose the cause of polycystic ovary, but what they noticed is reducing the ovarian volume improved ovulation function. The downside is that significant loss of ovarian volume and eggs, accelerating ovarian aging, and the other downside is severe scarring resulting from that, pelvic adhesions. So fast forward to the 1970s, when laparoscopy started being used, and it was noted that with biopsying of the capsule of the ovary, removing some of the parts of the ovary for sampling of tissue, that was shown to induce ovulation. So what has evolved over time is just using typically needle tip cautery. That seems to be the consensus in the literature, and that's what I use. Some people have used laser, some people have used the harmonic scalpel, but it seems as though the consistency is the cautery. So we use a needle tip cautery, and the ovary is like a golf ball, okay? And then we really just drill holes in the ovary circumferentially, not too much, because too much ovarian drilling could reduce the blood flow to the ovary, and that could result in actual ovarian, severe ovarian aging. Rarely it's been reported in the medical literature for ovarian failure. Okay, I've never seen that. But after doing this, the minimum number are 5 punctures on one ovary. But we typically will look at both ovaries and do maybe 10 to 15 punctures based on the size of the ovary. If it's not as large, we'll do a little bit less. The outcome, we see about 2/3 of patients start ovulating regularly, okay? And about 50% of them have a baby. So if the sperm analysis is normal and fallopian tubes are open, ovarian drilling is a terrific option for patients, or they can move on to in vitro fertilization. That's another option, of course. But ovarian drilling, insurance usually covers, so it's not as expensive as IVF. We usually will do this as a second line of treatment. First line would be using fertility medication, typically oral medication like letrozole. Clomiphene if body weight is low, but letrozole certainly if body weight's above 30, or BMI index is above 30. The other thing to talk about is that if you're not successful on the oral medication, then you can go to injectable medications. And it seems like injectable medication, similar outcome to ovarian drilling, but injectables have a higher risk of multiple birth, okay? The other thing I wanted to add is that the prognostic indicators seem to be a better prognosis in patients who are thinner. Okay, so I would say a body mass index of 30 or less are ideal. And also if the LH, which is one of the pituitary hormones, if the LH level is elevated, okay, lower LH seems to be less of a prognostic factor. Elevated LH you see classically in polycystic ovarian syndrome, and that's what increases the ovarian hormone, the male hormones of the ovary as well. So ovarian drilling, great option for patients. It is surgery. The average time of recovery is somewhere around 6 to 8 weeks of getting your period back. It could take longer. We've seen it as little as soon as maybe 2 weeks getting their periods back, and then 2 weeks after pregnancy. That's definitely an option, but we usually say after 3 to 6 months, if no activity and certainly no pregnancy, then moving on to either medications, going back to medications, or in vitro fertilization. We've had patients who've had several children from just the one surgery because they keep on ovulating, and studies have showed If it's successful, ovulation may continue for at least up to 20 years, okay? So, hope you enjoyed the talk on ovarian drilling. And this is Dr. Mark Trolice, Fertility Care, the IVF Center. Have a fantastic week, and we'll see you all next week. Take care.